Far away in the Andromeda galaxy, orbiting just out of its K-type host star Goldilocks zone, lies Reccembra, a nearly Earth-sized planet with nothing but deserted rock plains on its surface. But it wasn't always like this. If you know where to look, you will find fossils among the rocks, proof that this freezing wasteland was once a paradise teeming with life. But what happened to it? More importantly, how was the life of this place? Life of Reccembra. The beginnings of life. Life on Reccembra began in a very similar way to life on Earth. A primordial soup at the bottom of the early oceans. It was here where the first nucleotides were created by chemical reactions in the water. It took millions of years, but eventually, the first replicators were born out of that soup. No more than a single strand of RNA, all it could do was float around and wait for free-floating nucleotides not yet attached to other organisms to come to them and assemble into a double chain very similar to DNA, which could then split back into two complete individuals. While these were the first replicators, they weren't very effective. So when multiple RNA strands started to join and combine to form more complicated organisms, they were quickly outcompeted and went extinct. These new, more complex organisms use their secondary strands of RNA in a very similar way to ribozymes in our cells, using them to make the compounds and eventually the nucleotides that the main strand needed to replicate. As these compound RNA organisms began to get better at replicating, their RNA ribozymes started to not only make nucleotides, but also small molecular machines, the beginning of a revolutionary adaptation. Evolutionarily speaking, it took little time until these organisms had dozens of molecular machines working around them, slowly making nucleotide pieces for the ribozymes, proteins used for protecting the main replicating strand, ADP used for energy storage, and even more molecular machines. These new organisms had evolved their way out of the primordial soup, and now, as long as they lived in a nutrient-rich area, they could metabolize what they needed to survive and replicate. The only big problem these organisms faced was their own untimely demise, often caused by external agents, such as ocean currents, or simply bumping into the seafloor a bit too hard. Events like this would almost always destroy or mortally wound the main replicating strand and its ribozymes, without which the organism wouldn't be able to make more nucleotides or energy, assuring them their death. This all changed when membranes evolved. Once one of them evolved it, it was decided. Cells were now a thing in this world. The cell membrane was a revolutionary adaptation for these organisms. It allowed them to be protected while still being able to get the nutrients they needed, a function which they further improved by expelling specialized molecular machines out of the cell wall, enzymes, to break down the surrounding matter. This is where this chapter ends. Cellular life has now appeared in the oceans of Reccembra, and from now on, it will only continue evolving and diversifying into new and interesting forms of life.